In September 2019, Johns Hopkins, in partnership with the WHO, published a detailed report, and this is all part of that report, that is prophetic. For example, they warned NPI policies could be abused by overreaching governments for political social purposes, not because of evidence. It specifically says, in the context of a high-impact respiratory pathogen, quarantine may be the least likely NPI to be effective in controlling the spread due to high transmissibility. To implement effective quarantine measures, it would need to be possible to accurately evaluate an individual's exposure, which would be difficult to do for a respiratory pathogen because of the ease of widespread transmission from infected individuals. Quarantine measures will be least effective for pathogens that are highly transmissible, have short incubation periods, and spread through true airborne mechanisms as opposed to droplets. As with travel restrictions, quarantine appears to delay the introduction of highly transmissible diseases, not prevent their spread entirely. Quarantine measures also appear more effective with pathogens that had a longer incubation period, such as measles, compared to those with shorter incubation periods, such as influenza. These experiences with quarantine during the West Africa Ebola epidemic highlight the added difficulty of implementing such measures on a larger scale, which would only be more difficult in the case of highly transmissible respiratory disease. The value of taking any specific NPI intervention in a particular pandemic setting is not outweighed by the potential harm. It is important to communicate to political leaders the absence of evidence surrounding many NPI interventions and the adverse consequences that may follow them. It specifically says, beyond this, in the public setting, there is very little available information that studies the effectiveness of masks outside of health facilities. Now, there actually is quite a bit, which shows they don't work, essentially. During an emergency, it should be expected that implementation of some NPIs, such as travel restrictions and quarantine, might be pursued for social or political purposes by political leaders rather than pursued because of public health evidence. The WHO should rapidly and clearly articulate its opposition to inappropriate NPIs, especially when they threaten public health response activities or pose increased risks to the health of the public. I would say suicide by children, as well as adults, is definitely one hell of a risk to the health of the public. Okay, thank you.